This video will focus on the relaxation of smooth muscle. If you recall, calcium in the cytosol came from two different sources, the extracellular fluid and the endoplasmic reticulum. In order for muscle to relax, the calcium must be put back in those two locations. In skeletal muscle, this is done using calcium ATPase on the membrane of the sarcoplasmic reticulum, which is the same as saying the membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum. This also occurs in smooth muscle. So the mechanism for reabsorbing calcium back into the SR is the same for smooth and skeletal muscle. But you also have to get calcium back across the plasma membrane and into the extracellular fluid. Let's take a look at how this will happen. Here's the plasma membrane. There are two different mechanisms to get calcium back across this membrane. One of those is the calcium ATPase pump. That's the same pump that's on the ER, and in smooth muscle, it is also on the plasma membrane. The second type of transport on the plasma membrane is sodium-calcium countertransport. Is that a type of primary or secondary active transport? Secondary, right? Okay, so once we start reabsorbing or putting that calcium back where we got it from, then calcium falls off or, in other words, unbinds from calmodulin. That will activate myosin phosphatase. So you have seen phosphatase before. What does that enzyme always do? Dephosphorylates, right? It's going to remove a phosphate. So the phosphate is removed from the myosin head. When that happens, this will decrease ATPase activity. So decreasing ATPase activity prevents cross bridges from forming. So what happens to the force that the muscle can generate? It decreases. So that's smooth muscle relaxation. You will need to compare that to skeletal muscle.